Hi folks, I'm Stephen Crony. Thanks again for joining me today. I've got a sort of early morning winter sunrise scene for you. Nothing complicated, just a nice simple composition. Got our cabin here scraped in against the trees and bushes that sort of line about two thirds of the way up. And we've got two hedges lining our path up the hill to my little man and his dog and their little stroll over yonder. So let me show you the colours I've used for this one. So on the palette, the colours that I've used off the palette, we've got ultramarine, lemon yellow, raw sienna, burnt umber and light red. And the brushes, I got most of it done with a big height brush. Move them out of the way. The larger on Ranson height brush, there's a small flat brush and then a couple of riggers, a size 3 and a size 0. Had a nice surprise in the post this week. This is a proof copy of my new book, Painting Loose Landscapes in Watercolour, by myself. And I was quite happy with this one. Loads of new paintings in there. And what I've done this time, instead of using frames, which I used a lot of frames from the videos in previous books, whereas this time I've took proper photographs. And I think they've come up a lot better. So I think, I know I'm biased, but I think this is definitely my best book yet. So I've proofread it. I'm happy with it. So I've just got to wait for the processing to finish on Amazon. Just another few days, and it should be available. So I'll let you know as soon as that's available on Amazon. So I'm just going to begin it with some clear water. Stop it going all crinkly. And then start off with a bit of light red and lemon yellow, sort of orangey colour. Oh, let's see what that looks like. In the corners. Something like that. I'm going to give that a quick dry. I don't normally dry it that quick, but then as a consequence of letting it stay damp for so long means I don't get sharp details on the horizon. I've probably dried that a bit too much actually. Let's see how it looks, let's see how it goes. I'm just mixing the same colours with a bit of burnt umber and ultramarine. I'm just going to pop a few trees and things along the horizon. Do you know what? That was too dry. Just want to loosen it up a little bit. Over there, I'm putting a building in there, so I want that a little bit darker. So I'm just going to scrape into that. The rest of it. Switch to the little brush. Just pop a few little details in there. Now before that dries, if I just grab this piece of card and I'm just going to scrape that in there like that. Just use this little flat brush and make it a little bit darker on this side. Maybe pop a little chimney on it as well, a little bit bigger than that. And then back to the card, and then I'm just going to scrape just a few random details here and there. Fence posts. Okay, see, it's drying, so I'm going to put these on a little bit darker now. The rigger brush. Just going to pop a few more little trees in. What I'm doing, just mixing brown and blue with a little rigger brush. Size zero this is. Whoops! To do them too big, because I'll lose the scale of the thing. Right, now if I just switch to a lighter colour, I'm just going to clean the brush now. I just want to pop a few little lighter bits. I'm just going to give it a bit of raw sienna. Just dab a few little lighter parts here and there. A bit more colour on it. I just tap the ultramarine there just to darken it a little bit. Oh, I think I'm going to start putting the hedges in there. So I'm just going to experiment really. That's what I'm going to do. If I start off with this colour, I'm not quite sure what it's going to. Bit of everything. And then I'm going to start off something like that. Just loosely, I'm working a hedge up to about like that. I ain't worrying about where the paint's going or anything like any of that. Going to lead us, well, it's going to offer us like a path, and then I'm going to put another one in that's going to also go up there, and that one's going to sort of turn around and sort of take that sort of route up to the top, give us a nice little walkway. Let's just narrow that slightly. Let's just see what that looks like. Just going to scrape a few. fence posts and things in there. Brown, lots of brown and blue when you want to go really dark, I use. You want to get those really dark sections in. You'd have to wait for it to dry a little bit. And if you paint over that, you can always go straight back over it again, re-scrape it in. I don't want to get too dark. So just pause it for a second then, so I can have a look at it from a distance. Sometimes do. I'm just going to get the number three rigger now. Sometimes I just like to just place a few little random lines just here and there. Maybe a few in the distance there, a few little dark shadowy sections. Get your finger in there as well and just and things. I don't know what these things are, they just gives the viewer something to think about. And then on the path as well, I've started sometimes I like to just put in little marks. Just following the way that you'd be walking. Right, I think it's time for some shadows, I think. So what I'm going to do is make sure it's dry. Mix a shadow colour, get back to the height brush. I'm just going to go brown, red. I'm just going to get a bit of yellow in there as well because there's some in the sky. And then mix it something like that. Quick test, I think that'll be alright. I often just go foreground. There's like a tree or something on that side. A few shadows from these things. Draw. going to finish it off. Right up here, so I don't know how well this is going to stand out there, but I'm just going to have a little man. Just trudging up the hill. Little dog in tow. Little shadows coming from there, and I think that's just one little bird up there. I'm going to call that one done. See if I just sign the bottom bit now. I'm going to call that one finished, I think. If I just sign it down here, out of the way. Right, let's stick a mount on that now and see what it looks like. There's a finished painting in the main, so if you go and have a closer look at it. So the sky, predominantly lemon yellow and light red, give that sort of sunset-y, could be a sunrise even, sort of glow to it. And then you see all these different layers of trees and bushes and things in the background. It's because I've put them in at different times and they're sort of different tones. So this was like the shadow colour that I use in the foreground. Put it at the back and it gives that extra layer of depth. Lots of rigour work doing all the little trees and things. See what I was going to do? I was going to do smoke out of the chimney. I've completely forgot about that. You can see the cabin air just simply scraped out the roof and then filled the sides in with the flat brush, darker tones. Just scraped little bits and pieces here, posts and whatnot. Just looks like a mountain of detail there, but it's just all random marks it together. It just keeps the interest going. Lots of trees and stuff on this right hand side as well. More sort of depth and layers. See our little man there as well, trudging up the hill. Down in the foreground, just use the corner of the hake brush just to put the hedges in either side, just framing the path, like the lane that follows up the hill to the top. And then just use a simple mix, very sort of light tone shadow mix. Enough water to make it transparent so you can see the marks underneath. That cuts straight across. If you imagine that's casting a shadow, there's something out of shot, like a big tree or something, just casting its foreground shadow. And you've got little shadows there off the hedges. Winding our way up to our little man and his dog. So that's it for this. I hope you enjoyed that. Thanks always for watching, for your support. Especially all the patrons over at patreon.com/Stephen Cronin. Do join me over there if you get the chance. All the books are on Amazon, paintings on eBay. You'll see all the links in the description. So until next time, if you've got any questions, please ask. Keep practicing and I'll see you again soon.